Welcome user, in the last video we have seen how we can export different formats of file from MATLAB. We have exported .slsx, .txt, .csv image file and audio file. We have exported .slsx file by using xlxwrite function. We have exported .csv file by using csvwrite function. .txt file by using dnmwrite function. The function write table MATLAB always recommend for writing .slsx, .csv and for .txt formats of file. We also have exported image and audio file by using imwrite and audiowrite function respectively. In this video, we are going to see how we can organize different formats of data in the MATLAB. So let us start. We all know that standard arrays represent useful data structures for storing objects, but arrays don't allow us to memorize both numbers and string in the same object. This issue we can resolve by using cell arrays and structure arrays. Both cell arrays and structure arrays will allow users to store data of different types and sizes. First, we will see how we can create cell array and operations on cell arrays. After that, we will move towards the structure array. Here you can observe I have created live script instead of normal script. We can create live script by choosing live script entry which is present under new tab. Live script allow us to write, execute and test code in a single interactive environment. We can run the code selection wise and live script will display output alongside. Now let us discuss about the code. To create cell array, I have mentioned cell array 1 as a variable name. You can mention any name. After that, I have used curly braces to enclose objects. If object is numerical, then write the object in square bracket. If object is string, then write the object between two single quotes. In cell array, first I have passed matrix. After that, I have passed string. After that, again I have passed string. And you can observe in that string, I have mentioned wrong value of pi. At the end, I have passed empty object. To store the object from cell array 1 variable to workspace, select the selection and run the selection. Or simply click on blue color tab. You can see under workspace window variable is imported. To get output or to check objects from variable cell array 1, run the next selection. Over here you can check objects from cell array. To get data from individual object, I have used cell disp function. And in between two parentheses, I have mentioned cell array name. Select the selection and run the selection. You can observe output. Now check class of variable cell array 1. Class is cell. We can check class of variables which are present in the command window by using whose command or simply right click in the workspace window and choose columns. Check class option. You will get class of variables. Now see how we can access objects from cell array 1 variable. Write down variable name. After that pass the argument between curly braces. First argument I have passed second row and second argument I have passed first column. And for the below code I have passed all row and second column. If I run the selected portion right here, you can see output. If I discuss about first output, which shows value is located at second row and first column of cell array. Here, we can see value of pi is wrong. To make it correct, overwrite correct value. Here, I have used indexing and if I run the selection, value will change. Value of pi is changed. To check size of cell array, write down size of cell array 1. To check plotting of cell array, write down cell plot of cell array 1. Run the code and check the output. Before going for next discussion, first I will erase data from output window and command window. Now let us discuss about structure array. First I will create initial structure array. After that I will add second structure to existing structure. Patient of 1 will create first structure by using struct function. Between struct function I have passed field name and respective observation. Over here name is my field name and I have passed value xyz between square bracket. Age is my second field and value of age field is 17. Gender is my third field and M is my value which is assigned to gender field. Run the code, you can check output over here. To access particular value of field from structure array, write down structure name dot field name. And if I run the code, I will get value which is assigned to field name. Class of patient 1 will give class of structure. Size of patient 1 will give size of structure. To add new field to existing structure, write down existing structure name dot new field name and assign value. Also, we can overwrite any value to any existing field. Run the selection. You can check the output. Address field is assigned with mentioned value. Also, value from field name is changed. Now, I am going to add second structure to existing structure. Over here, I have assigned values to first two fields. If I run the structure, output will show four fields. Out of four fields, two fields having values and remaining two fields are assigned to empty brackets. To access any field from structure, write down structure name dot field name. If I run the selection, we will get all values of the field name age. With the help of rmfield function, I can remove any field name. Write down rmfield and pass the argument. First argument is name of structure and the second argument is field name. Run the selection, you can see field gender is removed from structure. In this video, we have seen data organization in MATLAB. In the next video, we are going to start next chapter, that is data preparation. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any query, post it in the comment or get in touch with us. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing.